Ciao guys and welcome back to my channel. This week we are celebrating a great milestone for the channel. We reached 100 followers, we passed 100 followers, and I would like to thank you all for all the support I received. This video is a text animation with an abstract background to celebrate. It involves different techniques and I hope that you will use in your own project. Let's jump in.
Let's start generating a plane, rotating it, and subdividing it into 15 subdivisions. We also generate a cube that will act as a particle. We create a hole in the middle of the cube using the bridge command. We duplicate the polygons of the hole and we create a separate cube of the exact size of the inner part of the first. We flip the normals of this new model and we fill the cap using the F key. We generate a particle system, specifically with hair on the plane. We check the number of edges and we put into the number of hair the exact same number. We emit from the vertices and we remove the random order. In this way, each vertex will retain one single hair. In object, we select instance object and we select one of the two cubes we created. We make sure to align the orientation and then we scale the main cube up. We then hide the particle system and we add a vertex weight edit modifier and a displace modifier. Make sure that the order matches the one that I am using. In edit mode, we generate a vertex group in our plane. This will affect the displace. We assign the vertex group and then we are ready to proceed with the modifiers. In the vertex weight group, we select the group and we set up the modifier the same way I'm doing, using a custom curve, inverting the curve and generating a new mask texture. For the mask texture, we use clouds and we will use these to alter the height of each vertex in a random way. We assign the same texture on the displace modifier. We can play a little bit with the attributes in a way that we have more or less white areas, and in this way we will have bigger or smaller raised vertices. We then add a null object. This null object will control our texture and will add randomness. Once we activate the particle system, each single cube will rise depending on the floor where it stands. We then duplicate both the plane and the particle system, making sure to keep exactly the same features. In the second plane, the particles we will use are the smaller cube. It's time to texture our product. We start with a dark gray color and we proceed to subdivide the main particle. In this way, we can assign inside an emitting material. Set the emission to 3 and the color as you please. Proceed to do the same with the other cube, but this time do on the outside part. Remember that each cube will act the same way when used as an instance. Generate a new node tree and add an object node to point a null object. Add an object transform output and activate the rotation axis. Using a time info, feed the blue socket of the object transform output. Place a math node after the time info and multiply by 0.1. Replicate for the second null object, but this time multiply by a negative value.
To make the particles move in a random way, assign each of the two rotators to each of the two particle systems. Let's add a text and load a new font for this text. I suggest something bold. Activate the plane and check the proportion of the text compared to your background. Make sure to transform the text using the transform size inside of the text panel and not scaling it up. This would mess with your modifiers. Extrude the text, give it some depth, and then duplicate to create the second part. Align everything. And then duplicate the first part. Increase the offset amount and reduce the extrude amount. In this way, you will be able to create an edge around your first text. Repeat this operation for the second text. And in this particular instance, you can start to be a little bit creative. You can generate multiple cuts for your text, for example. Let's add colors to our text. In this case, we use an emitting material on the edges and a white material for the main text. Let's add an empty object and let's connect our texts to that particular empty object. Make sure to connect the edges to the main text. In this way, you will have to rotate and move just one single object. Let's replicate for the second part of the text. We start setting keyframes on the transform panel. We begin rotating the first text 90 degrees on the Z axis and scaling it down to zero. After 10 frames, we set the rotation to 0 and the scale to 100. Repeat the same operation for the second part of the first text, but in this case, go up of 5 frames. This operation may be a little bit time consuming, so I am speeding up the video. Remember that you can animate also the rotator. Play a little bit with the parameters just to add a little bit of randomness and fun. Once you have animated both the text, it's time to start with the camera. We add a camera and a null object, and we use a track to constraint to attach the camera and focus on the null object. In this way, we will just have to move the position of the camera and the position of the null object, and we will be able to create a more realistic movement. Let's start focusing on the pattern and then moving away from it until we will be able to make the text appear. Remember that the keyframes can be also moved like every other single element, so just drag the full animation that you created before, a little bit after. Seeing that you animated the rotation of the text, you can still change the position, and you can do that just moving the null object that controls the positions of the text. We add 3 lamps, one that we will call main, one that we will call secondary, and the third that is the rim light. Make sure that the main light is the strongest, the secondary around half of the main light, and the rim a smaller lamp with white color and low intensity. Check the intensity of the lamps and the colors in the preview. Adjust everything you need to do until you can see your pattern. All you have to do now is just animating your video And as usual, I suggest you to render the video frame by frame to avoid loss of data.
I hope you liked the tutorial. Subscribe to my channel, like, comment. If you guys created something following my tutorials, send me. I would like to make a post with your works and show how you adapted my techniques. If you have questions, feel free to write me. I will be happy to help. For this week, it's everything. I invite you to follow me next week for another exciting tutorial. Ciao!